Southern Swing continues, this time in the region of Doom in single A, and a visit to Pearson with Coach McGowan in Atkinson County and the Rebels. All right. You have said that you were really excited and the guys are really excited this year. You've had a tremendous summer.
We had a great summer. Yeah, we went to a couple of OTAs. We went to one, the FCA camp up at Georgia Southern, and had a great time. We really came together as a family, and my kids are just super pumped about what's coming up.
All right, so let me ask you this. What was the biggest lesson that you've learned about your team from last year coming into this year?
We've matured. You know, we play with a lot of young kids. We came into last year with a really good football team, and we lost 9 starters in 3 games. Injury bug just nailed us, and we had to play a lot of kids, a lot of young kids, and those kids are a year older now, a year stronger, and I've learned that, you know, over the last maybe 8 weeks, that kids that were forced into action last year are actually pumped up about playing varsity football now, and they're bigger, faster, stronger, and able to compete on Friday night, where last year they were getting pushed around a little bit.
Okay, so when we talk about what life is like in the region of Doom, since I've already mentioned it that way, and that's the phrase that we always use, what's it like in the region of Doom in single A?
Well, you better get ready to play every Friday night. Yeah, there's no game in our region that you can walk into feeling good about. Every time you step around, you're eating a top 10 team or a top 5 team, or, you know, the last few years it's been the top 1 and 2 team. So, you know, you got to be ready to play week in and week out, and be a little bit lucky, and then also kind of avoid those injuries that are critical at times. But it for sure, it gives you the competition you need, that if you'd make the playoffs, if you're fortunate enough to be one of the top 4 or 5 in this region, that you're going to be successful.
Expectations this year then are what?
They're pretty high. We expect our kids to grow from last year. You know, we started out the year, you know, 3-1 or 4, you know, 4-1, and then we kind of fell on our face. And I think these kids have learned from that lesson. And not necessarily my goals, but their goals are to be one of the top 4 teams in this region. And, you know, the sky's the limit from there.
And one of the things that I like to talk about with people about this particular region is the great football towns and the counties that have wrapped themselves around these teams. What's it been like from your exposure here in ATCO, but at the same time going to all these other places?
Yeah, I mean, I think you kind of shut the streets down in these little towns. You know, everybody kind of closes up and shows up at the football game. This year, we've got a new assistant principal coming in from another system, and he's brought some great ideas. We're going to set up some tailgating areas for our Big Red members, our Booster Club members, and we're going to do a Rebel Walk that we haven't done before, where the kids go through they make a line for them, and they go through and shake hands with the people in the community, and then we've got a new tunnel this year with smoke and lights and everything. So we're kind of stepping our game up and hoping it converts over to the grass.
So what rubs off from all these other programs? I know it's shared information, but seeing the successes that's there, do you take notes on
that? Yeah. And you know, we as coaches and players, we don't get to see a lot of the pregame, you know, other than us going out and warming up. But when we go back in, we don't hear the national anthems and we don't hear the prayers and the things and the shows that are going on. And so I've had people that do get to experience that actually come in and tell us, man, you clinch shot off fireworks, you know, right after the national anthem, or Irwin had this huge thing going on. And so we're trying to kind of steal those ideas away and use them for our kids, because they deserve it just as much as anybody else.
All right, so my last question, and thanks for putting up with us again on the yearly tour. When you look at high school football, mm-hmm. If I was to come in here with a bejeweled crown or a TR or whatever, or a bejeweled high school football helmet, and was to put it on your head and say that you were king for a day, is there one thing about high school football that you would change? It could be on the field, could be off the field, could be something that troubles you the most. Is there one thing that if you were to wave that wand, you could fix?
We've talked about it as coaches all over the state. You know, we travel to these camps and talk to everybody, and they feel like we're putting too much on these kids too early, in that we're requiring them to work out in the summer for 6 or 8 weeks, where in the past we used to do 4.
Yeah.
And the heat is a huge issue.
Like today.
You know, well, yeah, all this week, Monday, yeah. Tuesday, Wednesday, we've been practicing in a basketball gym with air conditioning because of the heat bulb rules that we have to follow. You know, we're not able to be on the field. So I think I would try to work it out where we could somehow push our season, you know, 30 days back from where it is. And, you know, and I know that puts us way into the year, but take out some of the open dates, you know, take out a couple of the open dates and let's just play like we used to. But I worry about my kids when it's heat index of 105, you know, we just can't be out there. But Friday night we can be out there, you know, Friday night we're out there playing, but we're not conditioning in the same temperatures that we're playing in. So I'm concerned about that.
All right. Well, once again, thanks for having us again. It's always nice to come and visit everybody.
You're always
here
welcome.
In Pearson and ATCO. It's Coach McGowan. This is Life in Pearson, air conditioned for today. Southern Swing continues.
Thank you.